The first half of 2020 has put a spotlight on the business of information and entertainment. Few economic sectors have fared well, apparently, during the COVID-19 crisis. The media sector is one of them. The need for information has never been more pronounced and the time available so critical. Teams are collaborating remotely. Companies are collaborating sporadically. Is a future business as usual, or can this be a catalyst for the industry to reset and to build back better? This is New Technology Today, bringing you the hottest tech innovations straight to your screens. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. And, of course, subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell to keep yourself up to date. Predicting the future is not a glamorous job. The speed of on how we consume media and how technology enables new ways of interaction is so fast, you can't even predict what would happen in the next 6 months. A common refrain in recent conversation with the industry executives is that existing trends have accelerated, with 3 years of changes in 3 months. What we see around us is quite simple. Older people mostly use traditional media, while millennials mostly use digital media. Now please try to imagine what will happen in 10 years when all these young users become the majority of media consumers. Trends are here, people. We see changes every day. We change every day. Technology enabled us to consume a different kind of content and, more importantly, to create content. In the last 10 to 15 years, technology has changed human behavior more than ever, and it will change us even more in the future. By changing our way of consuming content, it will change traditional media as well. The future of media is continuing to turn digital media for entertainment, news, and business, which translates to major opportunities for businesses. The digital media industry continues to grow, with about 93% of American adults consuming some of their news online. As the audience for online media grows, so do the numbers of platforms, and more consumers than ever flock to sources born on the web. For businesses, maintaining an online presence that allows them to effectively communicate with their audience is critical. Digital media dominates how Americans receive and share information. As such, there are key influences taking shape that are likely to impact the future of the field. Innovation is a new norm when it comes to media, and that trend isn't likely to change as we look to future media concepts. Social media, digital advertising, and increased access to the internet through various devices have all shaped trends in media. Digital media continues to evolve as new tools emerge, consumers make new demands, and the quality and accessibility of the technologies improve. The rise of mobile video, virtual reality, augmented reality, and the more refined use of data analytics will all influence the future of digital media. During the time of the pandemic, there is a renewed interest in linear television. While the small window was thought to be irretrievably losing momentum, the time spent in front of the TV has never been so high. 4.5 hours in France, 3.5 hours in Belgium, 3 hours in the United Kingdom. The statistics are conclusive. While linear consumption was only decreasing in the face of the online media's blow, this drop was not spectacular. In 2020, confinement and the need for information and entertainment will, therefore, lead to an average increase of 10% in time spent in front of the television. TV audiences have increased dramatically due to the need for information. However, the halt in content production led to the channels to recycle content. This shows that traditional media will stay and will not die, but it will have to change and evolve. The TV will merge with digital, the print will become digital, radio already became digital. The coronavirus outbreak has prompted a significant increase in news consumption, but the economic turmoil is forcing news businesses to accelerate their move to digital. This prompted a global rise in viewing of television and online news, though concerns about misinformation remain high, with Facebook and WhatsApp seen as the main channels for spreading so-called fake news. The broader picture is that the outbreak is accelerating the trends wrought by technological revolution, including the rise of smartphones as an interface of news consumption. The biggest increase in concern over media misinformation was in Hong Kong, where the anti-government protests have opposed attempts by China to tighten its control of the former British colony. The business of news remains bleak. Media across the world are cutting staff to cope with a dramatic fall in advertising revenue. But a ray of hope may be that increasing numbers of people are willing to pay for news online, though that may also increase informational inequality as many cannot afford top quality journalism. And for those predicting the dominance of video news, the Reuters Institute found that in a number of countries including the United Kingdom, Australia, France, and South Korea, people under 35 prefer to read rather than watch news online. While the subscription economy seems to have swept the industry, there's still plenty of room to grow. Companies are still experimenting with ways to acquire, convert, and retain subscribers. Deloitte Global predicts that by the end of 2020, 50% of adults in developed countries will have at least 4 online-only media subscriptions. For those adults, aggregate spend on digital subscriptions they have access to, whether paid for by themselves or by someone else, is predicted to average over $100 per month by 2020. That's over $1,200 annually on media subscriptions. It's not just Netflix and Spotify ruling the subscription economy either. This shift can be seen industry-wide, including written media. The New York Times reported $709 million in digital revenue for 2018. Their thriving subscription model, which grew 18% to $400 million, contributed significantly to that impressive number. Digital advertising rose as well, but only 8.6% to $259 million. In the fourth quarter of 2018 alone, they added 265,000 new digital-only subscriptions. That boost brought their total subscription to more than 4 million, 3.3 million of which were digital-only. The publication aims to grow to 10 million subscriptions by as early as 2025. As paywalls become more commonplace, expect to see them become smarter and more dynamic. Artificial intelligence and propensity models can predict how likely a visitor is to become a paying subscriber. The amount of free media shown before the paywall can be determined by previous on-site behavior, for example. As evidenced by the digital advertising growth at the New York Times, ad revenue is far from dead. While Google and Facebook continue to dominate ad dollars because of their advanced targeting options, media advertising is still incredibly common. As with most digital transformations, expect a gradual shift. This has been the moment for media, entertainment, and platform companies to step up to their mission to inform, educate, and entertain. The current environment has undoubtedly accelerated trends that were in view 4 years ago. But more than that, what has come into sharper focus is the imperative to revisit long-held assumptions to rebuild, redesign, and reprioritize to create a more trusted, prosperous, resilient, and equitable industry. It will widen the gulf between those who have embraced digital transformation and social responsibility and those who have not. Just as importantly, it is a test of leadership both on an industry level, where collective responsibility and accountability will set the industry on a firmer footing, and at an individual level, where the blueprint for industry leaders is evolving to encompass agility, impact, responsibility, and authenticity. What are your thoughts on the future of media? Share your answers by leaving a comment down below so I can talk about it with you in the first hour. Technology has really come a long way. Find out in my related video, Revolution, Robotic Process Automation. Robotic process automation is one of the most exciting developments in business process management in recent history. Stay connected. Stay up to date.